Daniel Ricciardo and his fans have been waiting for his return to form ever since he joined McLaren at the start of the season. He finished in 9th last time out in Baku and was one of the drivers who lost out during the restart. He is yet to feel completely comfortable in his new team, and he has now revealed to Motorsport-Total his latest strategy to solving his problems in the 2021 McLaren car. I'm your host, Dillon Shelley, and first up on Formula World, Daniel Ricciardo explains why he took a step back last week. Ricciardo began by explaining how it can be difficult for a driver to pull themselves out of a hole. Like everything in life, Formula One is complex. Once you're trapped in a hole, it's very difficult to get yourself out of it. Based on my experience in Formula One, I'm pretty well aware of that. He then explained that it is not a case of hesitation in the car. Deep down, I know what I can do, and if I knew I was driving with a dose of fear or hesitation, then I would also know that maybe I should stop, but that is clearly not the case. He then listed his main problem. Sometimes I do what I think is right and what has worked in the past, but that doesn't work so well at the moment. Then you wonder why it doesn't work and it becomes frustrating. Ricciardo then explained his current strategy. That's why I took the step back last week. It gives me a better understanding of what the car is doing and what we want to achieve with the car. Now it's clearer to me and I now have to implement it on the racetrack. He then explained that his approach doesn't mean that he is starting from scratch. I was just trying to understand what was going on and how the car was working, what it took to make it work well. I don't want to say that we started from scratch because we definitely learned something in the first few races. It was more about trying out new things with a completely open mind. He then explained what he meant by taking a step back and how he is now looking forward to putting into practice everything that he has learned from this approach. I deliberately tested unconventionally in the McLaren simulator, including things that don't feel right. We wanted to find out why something wasn't working. You could say we played around a lot. And now a few things are clearer to me. I think that was really productive, and now I'm looking forward to putting all of this into practice. He signed off by being optimistic. I also know, as soon as it clicks, everything will be fine. Then people will jump back on the Ricciardo train. If you jumped off, no problem, the train continues, and tickets are still being sold, so it's okay, and I let people get on again. Fast feed. Aston Martin's Sebastian Vettel thinks that there is no quick solution, but the costs are far too high for someone looking to enter racing. Looking back to when he started, the costs were lower, but still high. He was very lucky, he was supported by Mr. Gerhard Noack. This was the same man who supported Michael Schumacher some 20 years earlier. Back then, it was already very expensive. Since then, the world has changed, sponsorship has changed. That may also apply to the willingness to invest money in young children and motorsport. In short, it's always been difficult, Vettel added. Defending world champion Lewis Hamilton doesn't watch a lot of rivals, but the new drivers are great. Lando Norris, George Russell, Charles, and especially Carlos Sainz. When Sainz got into Ferrari, he was very good straight away. He and Leclerc are a very strong pair. Formula One is in good hands. He also feels that the respect between himself and Red Bull's Max Verstappen doesn't have to change. Max is an extraordinary driver and it is very nice to compete against him. AlphaTauri's Franz Tost feels that his driver Yuki Tsunoda has to learn or he has to recognize when he's on the limit. He likes drivers who are pushing, he likes drivers who are risking something, but, of course, sooner or later you must get it under control, and that is what they have to teach Yuki. However, Tost likes it this way more than to try to make someone faster. Slowing down a fast driver is easier than to speed up a slow driver. If former F1 driver Kevin Magnussen, who recently won his first race in the IMSA Championship, had a Mercedes or a Red Bull, he wouldn't say no to a return to F1. He doesn't think many racing drivers would, but that's not going to happen. As he said before, he's very, very happy with the opportunity that he had in Formula 1. Not many people get to have that many years in Formula 1, Magnussen added. Red Bull's Sergio Perez thinks that his teammate Max Verstappen is a tremendous talent. From the first lap in FP1 to the last lap on Sunday, he is 110%. You see with the other drivers that they have days off. He doesn't do that and is delivering at a very high level. There is just so little time now and you can hardly do a setup change in session, so it's made it harder for those drivers who have changed teams. But overall, it is still the same for everyone, Perez added. Max Verstappen, meanwhile, has stated that staying at Red Bull is definitely the plan. He loves being part of this team. Personally, he has a good relationship with everyone. They are very motivated and driven, and of course, they want to win. Hopefully, they can do that for a long time to come. Can the often prohibitive costs of entering motorsport ever be fixed? Head over to my community page to vote in the poll and let me know what you think in the comments. And if you liked this video, feel free to subscribe and check out my others for all the latest in the world of Formula One.